Today in maths we're going to be looking at how to work out fractions of quantities, and this is again something we've practiced before in school, so this should be really good practice for us. I'm going to remind you of the two steps to success and then it'll be over to you. Well done. So have a go at the flashback four. Today the first question, write 6:45 in the evening using the 24-hour clock. That's a tricky one, and it's not something that we've practiced in year four, but I think that you might be all right from your year three learning. So have a think back to that one. Remember, the 24-hour clock shows the times all through the day, the morning and the afternoon and the evening. So we will be having a lesson to practice this next week, but see how you can go on today on your own, or maybe ask someone in at home because they'll definitely be able to help you. So write 6:45 in the evening using the 24-hour clock. Number two, order the money in descending order. Can you remember which way descending is? That's right, it's going down from the biggest to the smallest. Complete the particle model. Some practice on our decimals work then. Can you split the 0.45? One part is 0.4. What is the other missing part? And then Roman numerals. Write 81 in Roman numerals. What is the name of the 3D shape in the top right-hand corner? Brilliant. Good luck. We'll go through the answers in a moment. Okay, so question number one, write 6:45 in the evening using the 24-hour clock. So 6:45, if we weren't worried about what time of day it was, morning or afternoon or evening, 6:45 would actually be 6:45, wouldn't it? So 45 minutes past six, and that would be 6:45 or 15 minutes to seven. So we're partway there, but we want this in the 24-hour clock. So that means that when we get to midday, 12 o'clock midday is written like this. So 1 o'clock in the afternoon is written as 13, 2 o'clock as 1400, 3 o'clock as 1500. We're basically taking the 12 and adding on the extra hours. So it's 3 p.m. 15, 4, 16, 5, 17, and 6, 18, 100 hours. So 6:45 would be 18:45. There we go. So that's perhaps as much as any of you'll need to, as a little reminder, but we will practice this again next week in our work on time. Okay, number two, so order these amounts in descending order. We have £12 and 5p, so the zero there means we've got no 10p's, but we've got 5p. £12 and 5p, £12 50, £5 21. In descending order, that means we start with the biggest amount, and that one is £12 50. Then the next smallest is £12 and 5p. And the smallest one is £5 21. Well done. Oh, good. So for number three, we're going to be practicing that decimals knowledge, which we learned in remote learning from home. We've not done it ever in school. So fantastic work, guys. Let's have a quick practice. So we've got the decimal 0.45, and we have to partition that into two parts. In one part, we've got 0.4, and we want to know what the other part is. So I need to remind you that in a decimal, we have ones, then we have the decimal point. The first number after the decimal point is tenths, and the second number is hundredths. So in our decimal that we've got here, 0.45, there are 4 tenths, which is written here, And it could also be written as a fraction like that, 4/10 or 0.4. So what's missing out of our decimal is this 5. But we have to make sure that they are 5/100ths, and we write them in the hundredths column. That is the second number after the decimal point. So the other part is 0, point, no tenths because we've got them down there, and then 5. 0.05, and that is 5/100ths. So altogether we've got 4/10 and we've got 5/100ths, and that's the same as 45/100ths. Oh my goodness me, we are brilliant at decimals. Fantastic year four. Brilliant. Number 4, 81 in Roman numerals. Well, remember, for Roman numerals, we write the tens digit first and then the ones. So 80 in Roman numerals. We need to remember the letter L, which means 50, and then add on 10x. So we've got 50, 60, 70, 80. Wow, that means 80. And then we want the ones digit afterwards, which is just an I like that. So that is 81, LXXXI. Amazing. And the 3D shape is a cylinder. Spelled with a C, YLINDER. Maybe you can find some cylinders around the house. All sorts of different things are cylinders, such as tins, and cans, aerosols, sometimes packets, cylinders, or Pringles, yes. So if you can find some cylinders, that'd be fantastic. Well done. Great, so today's fraction work is about fractions of quantities. We're going to practice this today and tomorrow, and then that's it. We are done with fractions, and on Friday we can have a little practice of telling the time. So fractions of quantities today. And a quantity is a number of things, and I always think of Smarties. I just can't help it. Whenever I get a fraction of quantities question, I just can't help thinking of Smarties. It really helps me, so there we go. So as an example, I'm going to show you how to work out 1/3 of 18. And I've got my 18 Smarties here that I've drawn. Now, remember, when we are finding fractions of quantities, there are two steps to success. The first step to success is we have to divide the quantity, the number of Smarties, by the denominator. That is the number at the bottom of the fraction. And then the second step is to multiply our answer by the numerator. And there's a reason why that works, because if we want to work 1/3 of 18, we know now that thirds have 3 equal parts. So if I want to work out 1/3 of 18, it's really like a sharing activity. So when you were learning all of this method back in year 3 and a little bit of year 2, but mostly in year 3, you would have been sharing out your Smarties between the three boxes, between the 3/3. So let's do it. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And we've shared out all of our 18 Smarties between our 3/3 in the bar model. If I want just one of those thirds, that means that I want, I've got 6 Smarties. Okay, so what we did when we're sharing is we're dividing, isn't it? We did our 18 divided by 3 because we shared them between the 3 boxes. Now, the reason why we don't usually do all of this dot, 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 dot these days is because we have such fantastic times table and division fact knowledge. And we don't need to, because we know 18 divided by 3, how many 3s are in 18, that the answer is 6. I said that there were two steps to success, and there are. So we've divided by the denominator, 3. And then the second step to success is to multiply by the numerator. If the numerator is 1, that's not going to change the answer, is it? So that's why sometimes it feels like there's only one step to success. If in this case we wanted actually to know 2/3 of 18, and we didn't just want this one, we also wanted this one, then we would have done our 18 divided by 3 is 6, and then we would have done 6 times 2, because we want 2 of the boxes equals 12. So there you can see how that works. So I'm going to give you one to do now. Okay, so you try now 3/4 of 16. Pause the video and then start back when you're ready to check. Great, so there are two steps to success. We need to first of all divide the quantity, that's the number of Smarties to me, by the denominator, which is 4, and then we need to multiply by the numerator. Now you might have chosen to draw a bar model just to show why this works. If you have, then we should know that we're working out quarters here, so there are 4 equal boxes. So we're doing 16 divided by 4, that is the number of Smarties divided by the denominator. And the answer is, how many 4s are in 16? 4. So that means that we have got 4 in each box. The second step to success is multiply by the numerator. So get our answer 4 and multiply it by the numerator, which is 3. Because we want 3/4 of 16, we need 3 boxes. 4 multiplied by 3. And so the answer is 4 times 3, 12. Now, chances are that you worked that out really quickly in your head and you didn't need to use the bar model, because we've practiced this a lot at school, but it's been a little while, so I wanted to just go through that. So let's try another one now. Don't feel you have to draw the bar model, of course, but if it's helping you, then please feel free to do so. Brilliant. So there we go. To have a go at 2/7 of 35 and 3/8 of 48. Pause the video and have a go at these, and then when you're ready, you can start the video again. Okay, so 2/7 of 35. Remember, the first thing that we do is divide the quantity by the denominator. So we're going to do 35 divided by 7. How many 7s in 35? You should be able to use that multiplication fact. 7 times 5 is 35, and know that that is 5. If you were drawing a bar model, you will have had 7 boxes. Okay, and you will therefore end up with 5 in each box. Okay, second step to success, multiply your answer, 5, by the numerator. Numerator here is 2, because we want 2/7. We want 2 boxes, 2/7. And so the answer is 10. So although these look pretty tricky, they look a bit horrible, don't they? 2/7 of 35, you think, what? But actually it's easy when you know how. Okay, so 3/8 of 48, first step to success is to do our 48 divided by the denominator, 8. And this is where it's really important to know your facts. How many 8s in 48? 8. 16, 24, 32, 40, 48. That was 6/8. And again, ideally, we just know that. And then we've got our answer 6. That was the first step. Second step, multiply by the numerator. So take our 6, multiply by 3. How great is that? We've done it. So 3/8 of 48 is 18. Amazing. And that's all there is to it. So good luck with these, everybody. You're going to be absolutely brilliant. Send me your work on Seesaw. That's fantastic. Good luck. Done with you.